A variable speed drive isn't just a great tool for energy conservation. The smooth operation of many industrial processes require that the VSD be kept in working order. When a fault indicator LED comes on, it's important to diagnose the problem and get it fixed fast. But what if, according to the VSD's error code, the drive has detected an undervoltage condition and shuts down? We need to identify whether the failure is in the drive, the motor, or a distorted supply voltage. With a digital multimeter, we can check the line input voltage. But depending on the type of distortion, the peak value may not reveal whether a problem exists. When we check the VSD DC bus voltage, we find that it's about 20% under the nominal value. That's a problem. But do we replace the drive controller, the motor, or both? We need more information. Our scope meter will give us a clearer picture of things. We connect the scope to phase L1, L2, or L3, and the ground lead to neutral. A glance at the waveform reveals rounded, almost flat-top sine waves. Look at it compared to an ideal line voltage wave shape, and you can see the difference. Flat-top waveforms are typically caused by nonlinear loads attached to the same feeder circuit. Thanks to the scope meter, we now know that the problem doesn't lie with the VSD or the motor. The Fluke scope meter will graphically show not just amplitude, but also any distortion, disturbance, or noise that may be affecting the waveform, giving you the information you need to troubleshoot, diagnose, and solve problems. The more you can see, the more you can fix.